Today, we're going to look at simple connections. Connections enable you to connect to any third party or other Zoho services using OAuth 2.0 authorization. It abstracts the entire OAuth 2.0 authorization flow and keeps your code simple, clean, and crisp. Once you've configured a connection and linked it to your corresponding third-party account, you can easily access third-party APIs in your code by mentioning the connection's link name without having to worry about configuration, data storage, and access token regeneration. So let's take a look on how we can build a simple connection. Start by going under your setup to developer space. Click on connections. As you can see, I already have a few built. So to start one, you create connection, and it's going to come up with some default services. And these are ones that are already pre-built by Zoho to various applications that are out there already to be able to connect to. So it makes it easier. So you're not going to have to go worry about getting all of the client secret and client ID, all that. And we'll discuss that in a different video. But these are quick, simple setup, and it's fairly simple. You can even do various Zoho applications. And so let's just say we're going to go with projects. And typically, I try to name them that's going to be the connection name. This is the connection link name that you will put into when you're using different functions and like invoke URL, you'll need this name right here. Your scopes that are what you need access to. And so in projects, you're going to select, and you can select various ones. It depends on what all you're needing. Typically, best practice, any of them that say all after them is going to give you all access to that module instead of having to worry about going through and doing each individual one. You're able to just select the ones that say all. And so once you get all the ones that you want, then from here, you're able to create and connect. Hit connect, verify. This gonna give you, this is your scope. So this tells you exactly what all you're able to do in projects, and accept, and here's how it looks. So then when you go to use, it gives you an example. If you have to use invoke URL for your connection, put in quotes your link name, which is this. Some of the other functions that Zoho uses as well in Deluge that are built in. Some of them you will put that as the connection name as well. And what that does is it helps with going back and forth. It also gives permissions. Sometimes you may not have write permission. And if you don't include that connection, but putting the connection in gives you pretty much all access. And so they're fairly easy to set up on the, if you're using the default services. One of the things too about if you use the Zoho OAuth, its scope, you can pretty much do multiple ones. And so the cool thing about that is then you're able to do various modules and apps on here instead of just being limited to the one by going into like Zoho Projects we just did. That was just strictly Projects is the scopes it gives you, but the Zoho OAuth gives you access to all of the Zoho products. So I appreciate you watching, and check us out for other interesting videos.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.